Hello and welcome back to another gameplay slash commentary with your boy. It's Gyro the console scrub himself. Today we're gonna be playing on Noshar Canal's TDM with the Saiga 12K shotgun. Better stop running, dude, because it only prolongs your death for a half a second. Anyways, I hope you all enjoy this gameplay. It's a pretty good, and I go like 30 and 11 for, I think, just like 100 kills, so it's not too bad. I get like a third of the kills pretty much. We're going to have a few different Battlefield-related stories to talk about, including the very first one, which is Battlefield 4 to release by March 2014, confirms EA. So EA is looking to launch the fourth number title in the Battlefield franchise between April 2013 and March 2014. According to Video Gamer, which is a website, EA also touched on their future plans regarding the Battlefield franchise, stating that they are aiming for a window of 2013 to March 2014 to release Battlefield 4, which I'm suspecting it's going to be the latter of March 2014, because they said that the beta is going to be released in fall of 2013. Excuse me for that. Miscommunication with my speaking. So I don't see April 2013 that the beta will be out by then. I see, since they said fall, that's probably gonna be around August, September, October, something like that, and then we'll probably see the game probably in 2014. Now keep in mind that access to the Battlefield 4 beta is being handed out through each pre-order of Danger Close's upcoming shooter Medal of Honor Warfighter, set for release this October 23rd. Now, they have confirmed that access to the beta will be granted in fall 2013, meaning a release of Battlefield 4 between April 2013 to August 2013 would be highly unlikely, like I said before. We can safely speculate that EA will follow its current trend of releasing AAA shooters in the fall, or more specifically in October 2013, shortly after the Battlefield 4 beta, as was the case with Battlefield 3. So we never know, we might see Battlefield 4 by October 2013, so next year in October. I mean, if you guys really think about it, Battlefield 3 isn't even a year old. It's about to be a year old in October, so I mean, by the time that 2013-2014 rolls around, we would have already been playing this game for a while, and almost all of the DLCs will be out. So I think it's kind of cool that we have some type of release date to look forward to. I just hope that they can make Battlefield 4 as amazing as all of their previous games. You know, I just want them to keep doing better and better with their games and making greater like content for us to play with. So our second topic of this commentary is going to be Battlefield 3 Premium earns $37 million in sales with over 1.3 million subscriptions to date. So in EA's last quarter like report, they were showing the difference between FIFA and Battlefield, and FIFA was their top selling game of all time for EA at the time. Battlefield 3 has completely crushed that shit. I mean, out the door. I mean, while FIFA 12 is expected to earn another $17 million in digital revenue for the remainder of 2013, Battlefield 3 is expected to earn another 109, achieving a total of 188 million through the fiscal year of 2013. And what they're talking about is pretty much how much they think the game is going to keep earning by the time. I mean, with the whole thing of Premium giving you all of these free DLC, I don't know why people haven't bought it yet. If you haven't bought Premium, you should go out and buy it, because there's no point of you playing Battlefield 3 every fucking day to not have Premium, in my opinion. So go out there and get that Premium. But I think that's kind of cool that Battlefield 3 Premium has earned so much and has done so well. We can definitely expect, you know, a Battlefield 4 Premium once it does come out, since the Battlefield 3 Premium has done so well. Which pretty much, you know, the premium service is pretty much like the VIP service from Bad Company 2. So it's just the Same thing overall. And finally, our last story of this commentary for everybody. Battlefield 3 developer answers your questions, how to earn the M1911 S-Tag Dice's patching process, and much more. So we're going to be talking with Alan Kurtz, which is one of the main, or he is the senior gameplay designer for Battlefield 3. So people asked, why are there no US acquired RPGs or RU acquired small unlocks? So pretty much what they're saying is, you know how once you get 100 kills with the M9 or the MP443 pistol, you get the American acquired or Russian acquired gun for the other side. Now, if you notice, you can only use small on the US side and RPG on the RU. Pretty much what he said is, unlike the primary weapons, there is no real difference between the RPG and small, you know, so we felt it better just keep the weapons faction specific. And then they were also talking about how do they do the patches, and they were talking about how only some of the stuff can be changed with the client, which is the server that's running, while other stuff actually has to be patched with a update. So there's only so much that they can do. Commentary's coming in. If you guys want to check out the rest of the link, be sure to click down below in the description. If you enjoy, be sure to click that like button. We'll see you next time. Peace.